After covering the Australian rules football leagues of the southern states, I couldn't forget about the northerners and their rugby league state leagues. So here are the stadiums of the Queensland Cup. Totally Workwear Stadium, Brisbane Tigers. This ground recently underwent a major renovation that was completed just a few months ago. The old stand was relocated to another site, and a new one was built in its place. The Tigers are aiming to become the 18th NRL club, and if that does eventuate, they'll be changing their name to the Brisbane Firehawks, because the West Tigers already exist. Also, the ground will undergo further expansions. UAA Park, Burley Bears. This is situated in the Gold Coast suburb of Miami. I wonder why they called it that. The site that this park was built on was not quite as idyllic as the beach you just saw. It used to be a garbage dump, which might not seem ideal, but they've certainly tidied up the place since those days. And you can actually repurpose the methane gas seeping from the earth to fuel your barbecue. Brown Park, Central Queensland Capras. Rockhampton is known as the beef capital of Australia. Yet this ground is home to a team named after a type of goat. An odd choice, but I suppose goats are known for ramming into people, and that's basically what rugby is, so fair enough. A lot of the grounds in this league have recently been or will soon be redeveloped. This one is the latter. In its current state, it's a pretty interesting stadium with an eclectic mix of stands. Queensland Group Stadium, Ipswich Jets. This ground started out its life as a cricket and Australian rules football venue, but it has since become a ground that is exclusively used for rugby league and other sports that play on a rectangular field. Still, the oval shape remains. So, unsurprisingly, there has been a proposal to redevelop it into a proper rectangular stadium. But for now, it seems like a nice enough place to watch a game of footy. BB Prince Stadium, Mackay Cutters. This is the first stadium we've seen so far that was entirely built in the 21st century. And that fact is quite apparent just by looking at it. It has a clean and simple design, consisting of the main stand made up entirely of bucket seating that is mostly undercover, and over on the opposite side there's a huge grass embankment that runs the length of the field. Well, it's a grass hill really. A grass mountain range, no. Barlow Park, Northern Pride. That's an appropriate name because the club are situated in Cairns, which is the northiest city represented in this league, with the exception of one particular outlier. This is the only stadium in the league with a running track around the field, which isn't ideal, but the ground does also double as the city's premier athletics venue. Needless to say, they want to turn this into a rectangular stadium as well. Bishop Park, North's Devils. The Devils play at Bishop Park. Interesting. Well, I say interesting, but the ground itself is not very interesting. However, if I were to play Devil's Advocate, the Devil is an integral part of our society. Firstly, he acts as a counterbalance to angels, who are insufferable to say the least. He also invented deviled eggs. I've never had them, but they're kind of popular. He also gave us sayings like, the devil is in the detail, dancing with the devil, speaking of the devil. And finally, without the devil, we wouldn't have this song.
Me damn sure the pilot washed his hands and sealed his face.
Santos National Football Stadium, Papua New Guinea Hunters. This was the outlier I was referring to earlier. In case geography is not really your thing, Papua New Guinea is its own country. It's not part of Australia, although it was for a while. In fact, this ground hosted Papua New Guinea's first match in 1975, the year it gained independence from Australia. The design is pretty straightforward, but it's the largest stadium in the league, and the largest stadium in Papua New Guinea. The Hunters are also aiming to join the NRL. KO Stadium, Redcliffe Dolphins. These guys are the only team that plays at the same ground as their NRL affiliated club. I mean, they're pretty much one and the same. They just dropped the Redcliffe from their name. Oddly enough, there's a cricket team in South Africa known simply as Dolphins, without a place name. Anyway, enough about Dolphins. Prior to the Dolphins' ascendancy to the NRL, this ground was redeveloped, which not only improved the amenities, but increased the dolphin levels. Everywhere you look, there's a dolphin in picture or text form. Davies Park, South's Logan Magpies. The stadium opened in 1901, which means they started building it in the colony of Queensland, and by the time they finished it, they were in the state of Queensland, in the newly federated Commonwealth of Australia. Assuming they didn't get it all done in 1 year, which they very much could have given that it's a very simple stadium. It did have a speedway track around it back in the day though. Sunshine Coast Stadium, Sunshine Coast Falcons. This is quite similar to the stadium we saw in Mackay, with the main difference being the additional grass embankments at the ends. And that's quite fitting because if anywhere is suited for plenty of lawn seating, where you can bask in the sun, it has to be a place called Sunshine Coast. Much like Grimsby in Northern England, the name sort of tells you all you need to know. The stadium was redeveloped at around the same time that Mackay Stadium was built, so the similarities make sense. Jack Mangski Oval, Townsville Blackhawks. This is situated right next door to the North Queensland Cowboys' former home, which is looking rather shabby when compared to their new home. That is an upgrade if ever I've seen one. Anyway, we're here for the Blackhawks, not their NRL affiliate. This ground has an interesting assortment of stands, including this one, which you wouldn't call a proper double-decker, but there is a deck up top. Pigabeen Sports Complex, Tweedhead Seagulls. We're actually south of the border down New South Wales way, behind enemy lines, I guess you could say. It is less than 3 kilometres to the Queensland border, so you can see why they were included in the Queensland Cup. Clive Burghofer Stadium, Western Clydesdales. Cairns might be the northiest Australian city we've seen, but Toowoomba is the inlandiest city in the league, and at a little under 700 metres, it's also situated at the highest elevation above sea level. But I mean, pretty much all the other cities were right by the sea. The stadium's named after Toowoomba's richest man, a property developer who has donated a lot of money to the club. Speaking of names, the old grandstand at this ground that has since been demolished had the N-word in its name. Yet it was named after a white guy. BMD Coogari Oval, Wynnum Manly Seagulls. Coogari means seagulls in the Yugambeh language. Fun fact. Manly is a famous name in rugby league. But of course, that is the Manly in Sydney. Brisbane's Wynnum Manly Seagulls haven't quite achieved the same levels of success as the Manly Warringah Sea Eagles, but at least they're in Queensland, so at least they can lay claim to having nicer weather, as you can clearly see in these images. So there you have it. They were an interesting bunch of stadiums, my favourite of which would have to be Sunshine Coast Stadium. Yeah, it's not unique, but it just seems like a great place to watch a game. Please consider subscribing if you're new, and as always, thanks for watching, have a good one.